For the National Economic and Development Authority, the Philippines' participation in RCEP will be a game changer for the country. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan says it will help establish the country's economic standing in the ASEAN region. He also allays concerns by the agriculture sector, saying they will be well protected if the country joins the trade deal.
Yung pag laki ng investment ay yung nakakapag-improve ng job opportunities natin, lalo na yung mga magagandang quality of jobs. Without those investments, we can't expect to have a much more improved investment or employment opportunities, no? So kinakailangan natin ng investment. At siyempre, kung yung mga investors, lalo yung mga foreign investors, kung naghahanap sila ng kung saan papunta, papunta sila sa mga countries na malinaw na ang rules, na particularly yung mga trade facilitation, sa mga policies nila sa investment, respetado, na yun ay hindi binabago at any time, no? So by being a member, we are saying to the world that we are ready for business, we are welcome here, we play the rules of the game and well, and your investment is safe with us.
As Turkey winds down its rescue phase, the Philippine contingent there will be returning home by March 1st. They're also expected to cease search efforts by Friday as chances of rescuing more survivors diminish by the day. Since being deployed on February 10, the Philippine team has cleared 38 collapsed buildings in the Adiyaman province. They also recovered 4 bodies. The team also provided medical care to over 600 quake survivors. China accuses the U.S. of pouring fuel into the fire, rejecting Washington's claim that it may arm Russia in the war against Ukraine. China's foreign ministry insists Washington is the one shipping weapons to the battlefield.
The China-Russia Comprehensive Strategic Partnership of Coordination, which is based on non-alliance, non-confrontation, and non-targeting of any third party, is a matter within the sovereignty of two independent countries. We never accept any bossing around, coercion, or pressure from the United States on China-Russia relations. As a major country, the U.S. should promote political settlement to the crisis instead of pouring oil on the fire or taking the chance to seek its own gains.
Back here at home, a proposal to amend the Philippine Constitution gaining ground. A House battle on Monday approved a joint congressional resolution calling for a constitutional convention. The move advances attempts by congressional leaders to amend what they deem as the restrictive economic provisions of the country's 1987 charter. Lawmakers argue the restrictions left key industries underdeveloped.
There has been a lack of investments, and based on data, we have the poorest telecommunications industry in the ASEAN. We have very poor transportation infrastructure. Hindi nagdevelop ang mga industriya natin. And the fears that we have na baka pasukin tayo ng ibang bansa at ibang kumpanya na may agam-agam tayo, now we are more prone because we are not developed. These industries need to be opened up because we have one of the most restrictive economic provisions according to the World Bank, according to OEDC.
The resolution was passed after lawmakers held a series of provincial consultations. But an official admits the price tag for a constitutional convention and a plebiscite on charter amendments may cost billions of pesos.
We have an internal estimated cost for a constitutional convention. And it is, if it's going to be held as a separate national election and national plebiscite, the total cost would be 28 billion pesos. If it will be held simultaneously with the next barangay or national elections, the cost will go down to 331 million.